Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2 and welcome to this version control tutorial. Today we're taking a look at the Gitignore file. I'll show you how to create one and explain what it's used for. I'd advise you to watch my previous version control videos if you haven't already, Ace, since some of the concepts discussed in them will be revisited here. So let's get started. Here I'm creating a standard repository, Ace, and setting it up so that you can see all the windows correctly. Let's create our Gitignore file. Now, the standard way to add the ignore file is to use only the file extension without a name. However, if I create a standard text document and type .gitignore as the file name, it will cause an error. Usually you would add a gitignore file through the command line, Ace, but I'll show you how to do that in a future video. For now, if we name the file .gitignore. It will create the file without a file name. This is most likely a bug with Windows Explorer, Ace, so it might get fixed in the future. I'll add a simple text file, and if we pop back into source tree, you'll see that both files are ready to be staged. Okay, let's ignore the file we just added. Typing out the file's path with the extension will ignore the file. So if I type file.txt into the ignore file and head back into source tree, you'll see that the file.txt is no longer included in the unstaged files list. The file is now ignored, Ace. Generally, you wouldn't add a specific file path to the ignore file, since you usually want git to ignore a group of files. If I remove the .txt from the ignore file, the file stops being ignored and is available in the unstaged area. To exclude a file of a specific type, we need to add in a special file path pattern using the asterisk character. If we type in asterisk.txt, we will ignore the file.txt file and every file that contains the .txt extension. Now if I add another text file, it won't get included in the unstaged area of source tree. Let's take this concept further, Ace. Here I'm adding two video files with a .mp4 and .mov extensions. Updating source tree will include them in the unstaged area. If I wanted to exclude all files that have video as their title, I can add an ignore pattern to suit this. Typing video.asterisk will ignore all files that have video in their title, regardless of their trailing file extension. We can take this pattern a little further, Ace. Say I want to ignore all videos with video at the start of their name. By removing the dot in video.asterisk text, Git will ignore all files that start with video in their titles, and video not include .mp4 will be ignored. If I remove it and add in the ignore all.mp4 pattern, you'll see that only video.mov is included in the unstaged area. Okay, Ace, let's look at folders. Say I create a temp folder that is present in all the other folders. I want all the files in those folders to be excluded from my repository. This can be achieved by typing out the name of the folder and adding a forward slash to signify it's a directory. Adding an asterisk means Git will ignore all files that are in the root directory's temp folder. If we want to ignore all temp folders within the folders, we need to add an asterisk forward slash to the start of the pattern. This on its own will not exclude all temp folders, Ace, since the contents of the root's temp folder will still be included. Adding both ignore patterns will achieve what we want. Let's talk about comments. If we add a hash character to the start of a line, the full line will not be used in the ignore pattern. This is useful for adding titles or descriptions of what you're ignoring, Ace. Feel free to decorate them as well. Now you might be thinking to yourself, well, that's all well and good, but what if my folder starts with a hash character? How do I ignore it? By adding a backslash before the hash character, the gitignore file will use it in the ignore pattern. This also works with other special gitignore characters. Let's look at ignore exceptions, Ace. Say I wanted to continue ignoring all the temp folders except the one in the videos folder. By adding an exclamation mark at the start of the pattern, you're explicitly telling Git not to ignore the folder's contents. Here I type out !videos/temp/*. And now the contents of the video's temp folder is included. The same result can be achieved by adding a second gitignore file to the video's folder, Ace. This time, instead of typing out videos, we only need to type out !temp/*, since we're already inside the video's folder. This is a great little trick, Ace, but can get confusing if you overuse it, since it may not be obvious why certain folders are including or excluding files. Alright, Ace, you may notice that certain files won't be included by default in your Git repository. Here I'm attempting to add a .obj file to my project, but as you can see, it's not included in the unstaged files list. This is because of the global gitignore file. Click Tools, then Options from the top menu. Click the Git tab and you'll see a text field with the Gitignore list label beside it. If we click Edit File, you'll see that .obj and other extensions have been ignored. There are two ways to deal with this issue. Either remove the asterisk.obj text from the global Gitignore file, or explicitly include it in your Gitignore file. The choice is yours. Using the Gitignore file can be great for keeping your repository sizes down by only including the necessary project files. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, yes. I hope you're enjoying this series. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com to tell me how you're finding Git. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.